Chapter 8 is concerned with developing business-level strategy options. In many prescriptive approaches to strategy development, it's usual to define the purpose of the organization and then develop a range of strategy options that might achieve this purpose. After developing the options, a selection is then made between them. Chapter 8 is concerned with options development at the individual business and market level. Chapter 9 then considers options at the corporate level, where companies may be involved in a number of diverse markets. Chapter 10 then makes a selection between the options that have been developed. Back to Chapter 8. In theory, there are a very large number of options available to any organization. But we can capture these in two main routes. The first is market-based, and the second is resource-based. Within the market-based approach, there are three main areas. The first is that of Michael Porter's generic strategies. The second is the market options matrix. And the third is the expansion method matrix. Let's look at these three in turn. Porter's generic strategies has three main option routes. One is cost leadership. The second is differentiation. And the third is focus, involving targeting a small segment of a market. According to Porter, it's important to select between the options and not to be stuck in the middle. However, some influential strategists have produced evidence that has cast doubt on this point, and there have been numerous criticisms of this basic approach. The market options matrix identifies the product and market options available to the organization, including the possibility of withdrawal and movement into unrelated market areas. It's in the form of a matrix, which is shown on page 314 of edition number 5, and has four boxes: market penetration, product development, market development, and diversification. The expansion method matrix explores in a structured way the methods by which market opportunities associated with strategy options might be achieved. It draws a distinction between what might happen inside an organization and what might happen outside an organization, as well as drawing a distinction between geographical location in the home country of the organization and internationally. This is shown on page 319 of Chapter 8. They include such issues as mergers, acquisitions, joint ventures, exporting, franchises, and so on. In addition to the market-based options, there is also a range of options based on the resources of the organization. There are three main approaches to the development of such options. Number one, the value chain, which can show and identify where and how value might be changed within the organization. The second area is the resource-based view, which looks at such areas as core competencies and the reputation of an organization. Again, there may be options here. And the third area is cost reduction options. Opportunities exist in many organizations to reduce the costs incurred by the resources of the organization. And there are five main opportunity areas here: designing in cost reductions, supplier relationships, economies of scale and scope, the experience curve, and capacity utilization. Thus, these two routes, the market-based route and the resource-based route, structure business-level strategy options.